everyone, a very good morning to everyone. Okay, today I am going to say the unit 10 reading comprehension. Okay, this unit is in your English grammar book, so please you open your English grammar book and let us see what is there in reading comprehension. Here, reading, what is reading? See, reading is one of the most important skill. How the listening is one skill, just like reading also one skill. We adopt the skill reading, so we are a good reader. We become a good reader. So here we read a lot of things in our everyday life. In our daily life, we read a lot of, so many things we read. What we read? We may read from books, or we may read from newspapers, or food packets, or name of shops, etc. So, it is very important that we understand what we are reading. So, whatever we read, first we understand what we are going to read. Then there are some tips to remember while reading. Here, so some tips are there. Just we follow when we start reading, just we remember and follow these things. Okay, let us see which are the tips. So the first tips is, look at the pictures, if any, to understand what the passage is about. So when we are start reading the passage or the story, first we look at the pictures. So what is the picture, what are the pictures are there in that passage, what are the pictures are there in that concept, what are the pictures are there in that story. So first we see the pictures and understand what the passage is about. When we see the pictures, that time we get understand. So this topic is about. So when we see the crow we get an idea. So this story is about crow. So that like. Then the second topic is, read the title of the passage. So first we look at the pictures, then after that we read the title of the passage. So what is the name of the title? So what is the passage name? What title is there in this story? What is the title is in this passage? So just we read the title of the passage. So next, and the third tips is, read the passage carefully. So whatever we read that passage, or we read the sentence, or we read the story carefully. Okay, without any doubts, without any mistakes, we read the passages carefully. And fourth tips is, make pictures in your mind about what you read. So what we read, we get a picture related to that topic. Okay, whatever we read, so suddenly we get a picture related to that topic. And the next tips is, try to find the main idea in the passage. So after reading, just we try to find, what is the main idea in this passage? What is the moral? What is the moral of this story? So next we get an idea about the passage or about the story. Okay. See, related to this reading, some activities are there in your English grammar book. Let us see the activity 1. Okay. This is activity 1. Read the passage and tick the correct answer. So first I read the passage and tick the question answers. So the title of this passage is Hana's Hobby. Hana's Hobby. So let us start. There was a little girl called Anna. She loved to read. She used clues to help her read. Whenever she reads something, she first looked at the pictures in the book. She then read the title on the page. She is how she got a better idea. Yes, this is how she got a better idea. About what she read, she used to make pictures of what she read in her mind. So once again I'll read this passage. There was a little girl called Anna. She loved to read. She used clues to help her read. Whenever she reads something, she first looked at the pictures in the book. She then read the title on the page. This is how she got a better idea about what she read. She used to make pictures of what she read in her mind. So related to this passage, some questions are there. So just I tick the correct answer. So the first question is, Anna loved. What Anna loved? Anna loved to read. Okay, then what did Anna do first? So Anna first see the pictures. Then how did she know what the book or the passage was about? Okay, the third question is, how did she know what the book or the passage was about? See how she knew what the book or the passage was about? When she reading the title. See, when she reading the title, that time she knew what the book or the passage was about. And the fourth one, what did she do as she read? What did she do as she read? Okay. She made pictures in her mind about what she read. Okay. This is the right answer. So whenever she read, she made a pictures in her mind related to her reading. So this is activity 1. You complete this activity in your English grammar book only. Okay, let's we see activity 2. Okay, this is activity 2. The main idea of the passage or story, tell us what the passage is about. See, in this passage pictures are there. So first I see the pictures. Okay, when I see the pictures, I get an idea. So this passage is about trees and the uses of trees. So this passage is about trees and uses of trees. So when I see the pictures, so suddenly we get an idea about the passage. And then I read the title. So here the title name is Trees, Nature's Magic. Here Nature's Magic is a title of this passage. Trees are very helpful to us. There are many different types of trees. We get our food, that is vegetables, fruits, etc. from trees. Trees give us wood from which we make furniture. We get paper from trees. We also get cotton from trees. We make our clothes from cotton. We get beautiful flowers from trees, which are used for decorations. And to make perfumes, trees also give us shade. So this passage is about trees and uses of trees. So related to this passage, some questions are there. So I send these questions answer in your WhatsApp group. You write those question answers in your English grammar notebook. You write those question answers in your notebook. That is the part of English grammar in your notebook. Okay? Thank you, dear children.